Let's make an animated sprite. First, we need a sprite, so how about a little frog? Okay. Now let's draw him on the screen. Frog sprite equals 1. And that is his sprite number there. Frog X equals 59. Frog Y is also 59, and that will put him at a good position in the middle of the screen. First, we clear the screen. Then, we draw the sprite, frog sprite, at frog X and frog Y on the game screen. There he is. A basic sprite animation starts with how we set up the sprite sheet. The easiest way to code a sprite animation is by increasing the sprite number by 1. That means the very next sprite in the sprite sheet must be the next pose in the animation. I have already drawn them, so I'm just going to paste them in. To follow along at your own pace, just go to nerdyteachers.com. You can find the direct link to this lesson's page in the description. Here we have a frog going through the motions of one jump. So now, let's update the frog and increase the frog sprite by 1. Function update. Frog sprite plus equals 1. And that will add 1 to the frog sprite, but it will keep going, and then we won't see it anymore. So what we need to do is loop it back to number 1. If frog sprite is more than 9, then frog sprite equals 1. And there we go. It is that easy to make a simple sprite animation. But let's make it better. He's going a little too fast, so let's control the animation speed. We are going to use a built-in function simply called time. This time function is just a number that starts counting as soon as the game starts running. Let's print time to see what it looks like. So as you can see, the time function is actually a decimal that is counting the seconds. We can use these seconds in so many ways in a game. Basically, we want to know when something happens, like the changing of frog sprite, and then figure out how much time has passed since that happened. To do that, we first need a variable to save the time that the animation happens. I'll name it frog animation time. Now, we are going to set frog animation time to the exact time that we changed the frog sprite. Frog animation time equals the current time. Now we can compare the current time to the last time we updated the frog sprite. We can do that like this. Start with if, and then we are going to take the current time and subtract frog animation time from it. By subtracting these two times, we are finding the difference between them. And that difference tells us the amount of time between when we last animated and now. So next, we just need to decide how much time we want to wait. Let's just say 1 second. So, if the difference is more than 1 second, allow the next step in the animation. let's grab our animation code and put it inside of this if statement. So now, if the difference is more than 1 second, it will run this animation code. And if not, then it will skip the animation code and run whatever is underneath. Great! We now have control of the animation speed, but it's going way too slow. So we need to play with this wait time to find the right animation speed. Let's make a variable called frogAnimationWait. I have found that 0.05 is a good wait time for this animation. Don't forget to change the variable here as well. That looks much better. The very last thing would be to also make the frog move to the right while he is jumping. Moving right just means adding to the frog's x. Frog x plus equals 1. And there he goes, still hopping away off of the screen. So let's bring him back and even start him on the left side. We will reset his position just like we reset his sprite. If frog x is more than 127, which is the edge of the right side of the screen, then frog x equals negative 8. We're also going to change the starting position of the frog to negative 8. That's off to the left of the screen. And now we have our sprite frog animated and moving across the screen. You can do some amazing animations even with tiny pixel art. So practice drawing your sprites, playing with the timing, and changing screen position. All three of these working together make great animations. Now it's up to you to see what you can animate. Have fun and get creative!